you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hey, welcome, welcome this Sunday morning to Hope in the Word Ministry. We want to bring you hope in God's Word. Turn that down a little bit, sweetheart. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Bless you, Jesus. Hey, welcome again to Hope in the Word Ministries. Those of you seeing us live, hey, we're thanking you. You could be doing anything else, but you decide to tap in this Sunday morning.
Amen.
And we thank you for that in the name of Jesus. So we give you all praise, honor, and glory, Father, in the name of Jesus this Sunday morning. Hey, I'm Reverend Larry Pettiford, and in a minute, my lovely wife, Reverend Yvonne Pettiford, will be coming up bringing God's Word to you. I know God's got a word for you this morning. You hang in there. Don't you go nowhere. This is ordained for you this Sunday morning. Yes, yeah. It is. Hallelujah. Hey, let us open up with a word of prayer this morning. And welcome the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Father God, we love you. We praise you. We worship you. We give you all the honor and glory this day, God.
Yes.
Anoint the vessel that you decide to use this Sunday morning, God. My wife, Reverend Yvonne Pettiford, Holy Spirit, come up on her friend. God, give her a spirit of boldness to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ to those that are watching live, those that will watch later in the name of Jesus, dear God. So we give you the glory, God. Touch, heal, deliver those out there from the oppressions of Satan and his principalities. In Jesus' name, if you agree with me this Sunday morning, say amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hey, we worship you, God. Oh, this is the day the Lord has made. I'm excited.
Hallelujah.
Any day that he allows me to be on this earth, because my home is in heaven.
Yes.
But he allowed me to be here through sickness, through pain, all the issues. I got troubles too. And I know you do too.
Hallelujah.
Hey, do me a big favor. If you need prayer, do me a favor. Go to our website, www.hopeintheWordMinistries.com. Click on prayer request. You don't need to put your name on there. I was sharing with some people yesterday. I said, man, I always say send us a prayer request. Then I look later, ain't nobody sent a prayer request. I mean, hey, I guess they're good. So if you need a prayer and you got a request, send it to us. Go to hopeintheWordMinistries.com. Check our website out anyway. You'll find out about us, things we're doing. And if you don't need prayer, I tell you what, me and my wife were saying yesterday, we need prayer.
Yes,
will you pray for us? Go there and just type in, hey, we're praying for you. If you're watching this live on Facebook, hey, let us know you're there. Tap in. Hey, shoot something to us. Let us know you're tapping in. Hey, Rev, we're right there with you. Pray for us. We're praying for you. We appreciate it. Also, we need your financial support to continue to advance the gospel. On our website, there's a donate button. Click donate. Your gift, large or small, will continue to help us to help others. Here in Phoenix, like I said, Phoenix Rescue Mission, we're continuing to want to buy cases of water to take down there year-round because here in the valley, the homeless are on the street, and we want to be a blessing to them.
Amen.
And we want to continue to reach out to those that are lost, that are hurting. Amen. So will you help us financially? I know if you do, God will bless you.
Amen.
Hey, again, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I have one other thing. Continue to trust God no
Amen.
Matter what you're going through. You got to trust him like never before. We're living in a time now that you got to trust in the Lord like never before. The scripture I want to read this morning is in Luke 1:37. Luke chapter 1, verse 37. In the NIV, it says this. For with God, listen to this.
Mm-hmm.
Luke chapter 1, verse 37. You need to start writing things down. Luke chapter 1, verse 37. Meditate on this during the week. It says this. For with God, nothing is impossible.
Amen.
I'm not the preacher this Sunday morning, but I tell you what, I get happy on that.
Yes.
For with God, nothing. That means nothing.
Hallelujah.
That thing you're facing, that trouble, that trial, it seems like, man, I don't, it's just not going to work out. Yes, it will. Oh, I got to do this. Don't go nowhere. I told you I'm not to preach. But see, Jesus went to this cross right here.
Amen.
To die for my sins and your sin. For with him, nothing is impossible. He paid a debt that I couldn't pay, you couldn't pay. He laid it on this cross. It's finished. It's done. Don't let the devil whisper in your ear and say you got too far away from God. I was talking to a guy when I was at my dialysis treatment. And he said, I feel like God is mad at me. Everything is going wrong. I said, oh, brother, no, no, no. God is never mad at you. You need to quit listening to the devil. Oh,
man.
Thank you for tapping in. You're here at the right time.
Yes.
You didn't stumble in here to Hope in the Word Ministries. No, you didn't. God ordained you might have been just trolling through and seen live. And you just said, let me see what they're doing. Don't you go nowhere. Stay right where you're at. Because Jesus went to this cross. He paid that debt, like I said, that I couldn't pay, you couldn't pay. He loves you no matter what.
Amen.
That's why he said he came for the sick, not the healthy. I don't know about you. I got sick things in my life. And I thank him and I praise him. But Luke 1:37, for with God, nothing
Amen.
Is impossible.
Hallelujah.
Oh, you need to marinate on that. You need to lay on that. You need to trust God, for with God. Now, with me, it may be, it's impossible. With God and what Jesus did on this cross, it's not impossible. Hey, right about now, I'm going to introduce to you my lovely wife, my queen, my everything, my prayer partner. Reverend Yvonne Pettifer is going to come and bring an anointed word to you. So you don't go nowhere. You stay where you're at. Like I said, visit our website. Can you do that for me? Send me a prayer request. We would love to pray for you. See, we believe, for with God, nothing is impossible.
Amen, amen, amen.
For with God, nothing is impossible. That's in Luke chapter 1, verse 37. Hey, I love you. Don't you go nowhere. You keep the faith. You're facing things like I'm facing things. If I had time, I would tell you all. But I know a God in heaven while I'm on this earth. He's seeing me through.
Yes.
I'm carrying my cross. You carry yours. At this time, my lovely wife, Reverend Yvonne Pettifer, got an anointed word for you. Be blessed.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. Welcome
Hallelujah.
To Hope in the Word Ministries.
Yes,
my husband,
yes, Sam, yes.
I'm Reverend Yvonne Pettifer. Mm-hmm. We're so glad that you're here with
yes,
us this
yes.
morning. Hallelujah. We just thanking God for this beautiful day, thanking
yes.
God for Jesus Christ who died on that cross.
Yes.
And I'm going to come to you this morning from Jeremiah 18, 1 through 4. I'll give you a
yeah.
moment to find
yeah.
that. If you have a Bible, open up to Jeremiah 18, 1 through 4. If you don't, you know, if you don't have a Bible, you know, open up on your laptop, your iPad, whatever. If you don't have that, you're just watching on your phone or wherever you're watching, just open up your heart, as I always say. Open up your heart to the
yes.
Word of God.
Hallelujah.
And listen to what He has to say, what He has to receive. And you can always go back and read it later.
That's right.
All avenues. We have so much technology, books, Bibles. There's no reason that we cannot read God's Word.
That's right.
None whatsoever. So we're just going to get started this morning. Jeremiah 18, 1 through 4. It says, the word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause you to hear my words. Then I went down to the potter's house, and there he was, making something at the wheel. And the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter.
Mm.
So he made it again into another vessel, as it seemed good to the potter to make. May the Lord add the blessing to the reading of his holy word. Let's
Hallelujah.
Just close our eyes in prayer.
Amen.
Our Heavenly Father, we just thank you. We lift up this word to you. We just thank you and lift up this time of worship, this time of receiving your word, this online live streaming, whether it's now or later. We just ask that you touch the hearts and the minds and the souls of those that are watching. Give them ears to hear. Let me decrease, that you increase. It's not about us. It's all about you. And we just thank you for Jesus Christ who died on that cross to save our sinful souls. And we're here to be soul winners for Christ, that lives are changed, that someone's life is written in that Lamb's Book of Life today, and that there's hope given to those that hear these words. And we just thank you, and we lift it all up to you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen,
amen, amen. 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 My title is Everything You Need is in the Potter's House. Everything you need is in the Potter's House. So we're going to look back at that scripture. And before I get into that, it says, you might feel like there is no hope for you today. As my husband said, somebody's saying, you know, sitting there thinking that God is mad at them. That God wants nothing to do with them. You might need a new beginning spiritually. You might need a new beginning emotionally. You might need a new beginning in your mind. You might have past regrets, feeling guilty, making you feel ashamed. See, Satan wants to keep you right there. He doesn't want you to get to the Potter's House. He might be telling you this morning that God wants nothing to do with you, that you've done too many wrong things in your life, and that you're too far from God. God is speaking to you this morning.
That's right.
He's a God of second chances. Oh, I'm so thankful that he is.
Preach.
He's
Amen.
A God of third chances.
Yes.
He's a God of fourth chances, and it keeps going. As long as you have breath in your body, he is not going to give up on you. He is not going to throw you away.
Amen.
He is not mad at you. He is not angry with you. He might discipline
Hallelujah.
You because he loves you.
Hallelujah.
Everything you need is in the Potter's House, and that's where we're going this morning. Let's look back at verse 1. We're going to take those four verses, kind of break them down. Let's take a look at it.
Hallelujah.
The word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord saying, that's verse 1. See, the word came to Jeremiah. I put my name in there.
That's right.
Make it personal. The word which came to Yvonne. From where? From the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Saying he has something to say. God has a word for you this morning. He has something to say to you. Put your name in there. The word which came to Yvonne, with the word which came to Jeremiah from straight from the Lord, saying he had something to say.
Yes.
God has a word for you today. He's trying to talk to you this morning. Whenever you're watching, I don't care if it's midnight. I don't care if it's 10 o'clock at night, 2 o'clock in the morning. God is always there. He has something to say to you. He has a word for you today, but you gotta listen to it. What is he saying to you today?
Thank you, Jesus.
But if you want to know what God is saying to you, you've got to do something. What is he telling you in verse 2? It says, arise and go down to the potter's house.
That's right.
And there I will cause you to hear my words. Who is the potter? God Almighty.
That's right.
God is the potter. I'm so glad he is. See, some of you might be sitting there. Satan might be trying to mold you. And me, I'm just throwing some stuff out there now that's just coming to me, because Satan might be having his hands on you and trying to mold
Jesus.
You and send you over here and over there. He doesn't want you to get to that
come
potter's
on,
house
come on,
this
yes,
morning.
Yes,
see,
yes.
He doesn't want you to hear from God, because he knows once you hear from God, you start hearing that word, your life is going to change because of God's word. He's trying to keep you from the potter's house. See, he says, arise. Arise means to get up. Get up. He says, arise and go. Arise and get up. Get up and go somewhere. Go to the potter's house. Get up and go. Go where? To the potter's house. Something is happening when we keep reading in the potter's house. Everything you need is in the potter's house. Satan knows that. That's why he doesn't want you to go there.
Yes. Hallelujah.
See, I wrote down some notes, and there's so many things in here, these four verses, in the potter's house. There's so much in that potter's house. That salvation. Get up and arise. Arise and go to the potter's house. Get up off of that couch. Get out of that bed and get to church.
Come on.
Get to Bible study.
Come
get
on.
Get to prayer meeting where
Come
you can
on.
Hear from God.
Yes.
If you say, I can't get out, or you don't go, get up in your heart. Come on. Meet God in your heart this morning so you can hear his words.
Yes.
Get to the altar this morning.
Yes.
Make an altar. Lean down on your couch. Kneel down there. Raise up your hands.
Yes.
Meet God where you're
Hallelujah.
At. Get to the potter's house this morning. Maybe you need to clear your mind so you can hear his words.
Yes,
so get alone with God this morning so you can hear his words. Because what did he say? He said, go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause
you
to hear
Jesus.
My words. Whose words? The words of God.
That's
he
right.
wants to speak to you this morning.
Well,
he wants
preach.
You to hear his words, because there's deliverance when you get to the potter's house. Get alone with him this morning.
Yes.
You got to do something.
Hallelujah.
Get up. Don't sit there. Get out of that pity party that you're in. Get out of that woe is me party that you're in. Get out of that God doesn't love me
That's
anymore.
A good word.
That God doesn't care about me. That God is mad at me. Get up and get away from there. See, when you get to the potter's house, you can leave all that other stuff behind. Mm-hmm. Come on. Get to the potter's house. Get out of that confusion. Get out of that doubt.
Yes, come
get
on.
Away from that fear. Get to the potter's house. Satan doesn't want you to. He wants to keep you bound up. He wants to keep his hands on you so you don't have any freedom in Christ. Get away from that. Shake him off. Get up where you're at. If you can't go anywhere, get up off that couch. If you're bound and you can't get up, you can lift up your hands, lift up your heart, lift up your mind. Shout hallelujah.
Yes.
Something. Get to the potter's house. Get Satan's hands off of you because you want God's hands on you. He's the potter this morning.
That's good.
He's got something to say to you this morning.
Hallelujah.
So verse 3. And I said there's just 4 verses.
Come on,
but there's
come
a
on,
whole
come
lot packed in those 4 verses.
Thank you, Jesus.
Then I went down to the potter's house. Oh, yeah. See, this is about Jeremiah, but it's about you.
Yes.
Then he's talking. He says, then I went down to the potter's house. Talking to myself. Yvonne, me, I don't know. Maybe you don't want to go. But see, I need to be at the potter's house. I went down to the potter's house. We're going to finish this. Then I went down to the potter's house, and there he was.
Come on.
There he was. He was making something. At the wheel. When you get to the potter, something happens. I opened up my heart, and there he was. I opened up my mind, and there he was. I got on my knees and prayed, and there he was.
Hallelujah.
I got in my room and shut the door.
Hallelujah.
And there he was. I got away from the people I shouldn't be around, and there he was. Get to the potter's house. I shook off that confusion.
That's right.
And there he was. I started saying, I'm not going to be afraid anymore. And there he was. I got away from doubt. And there he was. Oh, yes. See, I went down to the potter's house. And there he was. But he was doing something. He was doing something when Jeremiah got there. What was he doing? Said he was making something at the wheel.
Come on. That's a good
word.
He
was always working. He was already working. Everything you need is in the potter's house. He was making something at the wheel. Oh, doesn't that just do something for you? Who's the potter? God is the potter. He is working. He's working in your life. You might not see it, but you got to get to the potter's house. You got to hear his words. You can't see him. Why? Because you're not in the potter's house. You can't hear him. Why? You're not in the potter's house. But I looked at that this morning. I was like, hallelujah. That was something that just, I'd never seen that before. He was already working. Oh, hallelujah. God is always working.
Come on.
He was making something at the wheel. Ooh, can you just
see
it?
Thank you, Jesus.
I always loved the potter's wheel. I'm just kind of going off person. I always loved that potter's wheel and just that clay on that pottery wheel and just molding that clay. Forming that clay into what God wants it to be. Hallelujah. I can just see it.
Thank you.
Jeremiah went down to the potter's house, and he said, there he was. There God was. He was making something at the wheel. Ooh, God was making something happen.
Thank you.
He is working in your life. Everything you need is in the potter's house. Hallelujah. Go back and read it this week. Just repeat those words. If you just have to say, I got to get to the potter's house.
Thank you, Jesus.
Every day, Lord, I got to get to the potter's house. Oh, what I need is in the potter's house.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Everything you need is in the potter's house.
Hallelujah.
Let's look at verse 4. And the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter. So he made it again into another vessel as it seemed good to the potter to make. Hallelujah. What is a vessel? It's a hollow container. See, it's used to hold something. What are you being filled up with?
That's right.
What are you being filled? What's being poured into you? Is it what God wants to be poured into you? Is it what Satan's trying to pour into
That's
you?
Right.
Is he trying to pour bitterness into you?
Is
he trying to pour anger into you? Is he trying to pour unforgiveness into you? Is he trying to pour hate? Is
Come
he trying
on.
To pour fear, doubt, confusion, hopelessness, unhappiness, a messed up mind? See, that hollow container got to be filled with something. See, we have all kinds of things coming at us every day. What is that hollow container being filled with? Honorable things for the glory of the Lord, or dishonorable? What comes out, what comes in, what's in you is what's going to come out of you.
Mm, that's good.
Mm-hmm. So if you have a pot and you're pouring anger and bitterness and hate, when you open up your mouth and you pour that out, that's what's coming out.
That's right.
But if you pour in the love of God, if that Holy Spirit is in you, that's what's going to come out.
Mm-hmm.
See, what is in that vessel of you? What if you are that vessel? What is poured into you? What's going to come out? That clay, what is that clay? Just that made from the earth, that mud. That material, that earth material, which the human body was formed. See, God was at the wheel. He had that clay in his hands, but it was marred. It was messed up. It was blemished. It was imperfect. We are the clay. You are the clay. God wants to mold us into what he wants us to be. But you know what I like about that when I looked at that scripture, hallelujah? See, that clay, that pot, whatever, was messed up.
Mm-hmm.
It was marred. But what does it say? God's hand were on it. He didn't throw it away and say it's not any good anymore. God's hands was on that marred clay.
Come on.
God's hands are still on you. Trust in him.
Mm-hmm.
Give your life to him.
Come on.
Have hope in him.
Yes, yes.
In his word. Get to the potter's house.
Mm-hmm.
Just cry out to him. See, he didn't throw you out.
Hallelujah.
Sometimes when that clay pot drops on the ground, what happens to it? It breaks and it gets shattered. See, our lives, we might feel shattered on the inside. Our hopes and dreams shattered because Satan has messed with us too much and we think there's no hope. Oh, no. See, that scripture right there, I'm going to go back to it because
he said
the clay was marred in the hand of the potter.
That's
God is the potter. He's got his hand on you. He didn't throw you out just because you messed up.
Mm.
He didn't throw you out because something you did this morning or last night or whatever. He didn't throw you out. No, he loves you. And
yes.
He's got you on that wheel. Come on.
Thank you,
Trust
Jesus.
In him. It says it was marred. It was messed up. But God's hand is still on it.
Hallelujah.
You might be messed up this morning. But God's hand is still
That's
on
right.
it. Oh, yes, it is. I don't know what you've done. I don't know where your life is. But God's hand is still on you. Hallelujah. See, there's so much in God's word. That's why we have to be in God's word every day. That's why we have to pray and meditate on it. Let God reveal things to you. I've read the scripture before, but I'm telling you, reading this story, God gave me some new revelations in here that I hadn't seen before. He'll do it. A scripture that you've read over and over and over.
Hallelujah.
He'll bring some new things out
mm-hmm.
to you. So I'm going to go back here. The vessel of clay was messed up.
Mm-hmm.
It's not perfect. We're not perfect. It was broken, blemished in his hand. Oh, I'm so
That's
glad
good.
He didn't take his hands off of me. I'm just talking personally now. I'm so glad that he didn't take his hands off of me when
mm-hmm.
I mess up.
Yes, yes.
That he loves me enough.
Yes, preach. Take your time.
That he loves me enough.
Mm-hmm.
It was in his hands. Oh, I want to be in the potter's hands.
Yes.
Don't take your hands off of me, Heavenly Father. Keep molding me and making me into what he wants me to be.
Mm-hmm.
As long as you have breath in your body,
there
is hope. Don't give up. There is hope.
Mm.
Everything you need is in the run to the potter's house.
Hallelujah.
I mean,
I said,
get there as fast as you can. Don't worry about anybody around you. Don't care what anybody else thinks.
Mm-hmm.
Get to the potter's house. If that means just falling on your knees and
hallelujah.
Shouting hallelujah, if you're in the grocery store and you have to get to the potter's knees right there where you're at, don't worry about anybody else.
Hmm.
You have to pull over your car,
the
side of the road,
That's
and
right.
start shouting. Get out and start shouting. I'm going to the potter's house.
Hallelujah.
Meet him where you're at. Go to the potter's house. He'll be there.
Mm.
He's waiting for you.
Mm-hmm.
And he's already working. Working for who? Working for you.
Mm-hmm.
Because he loves you that much. As I said, you might be marred this morning. You might feel broken this morning. You might feel unloved this morning. Oh, yeah, many people do. We're coming into that time of season. And these things are not in my notes, but we're coming into that holiday season. And it can be the happiest time, and it can be the saddest
That's
time.
Right.
But And see, the suicide rate goes high up. I wasn't even planning on talking about that, but you might feel unloved and think that God doesn't care because you're lonely. The holidays will bring that out. It'll bring out joy and it'll bring out sorrow.
That's right.
Yeah. Hallelujah. And it's about the birth of Jesus Christ, because he came here because we're broken. He came here because we're messed up.
Come on, because we're marred.
Because he came here because we're not perfect.
Mm-hmm.
But even if you don't have anybody around you, he'll be your friend. No, don't let the holiday season swallow you up. Don't let it come down
on
you. Don't let that depression get to the potter's house.
That's right. Get to the potter's
house. Come on. He'll be your friend. He'll be your comforter. He'll be your counselor. He'll bring somebody into your life that will lift you up.
Yes.
Somebody that will speak a life into you. Yes, he will. Don't sit there feeling sorry for yourself.
Thank you.
And say nobody loves you. Yes, he does. God loves you.
Bless you,
Jesus loves you.
Yes,
if he didn't, he wouldn't have died on that cross for you.
Come on, preach that thing. Mm-hmm.
Come on now. Get to the potter's house. Everything you need is in the potter's house.
Yes,
everything
that
you need is in the potter's house.
Hallelujah.
And I keep going back to that because somebody needs to understand that. Mm-hmm. That marred clay was still in his hands.
Take your time. Work that.
That marred clay was still in his hands. You're messed up. Your mind is messed up. Your heart is messed up.
Mm-hmm.
But you're still in God's hands. He didn't throw you away just because you're broken up.
Yes, yes.
Mm-mm. Don't let Satan lie to you.
Because
he'll mess up your mind if you let him.
Mm-hmm.
That's why God said, get to the potter's house. He will cause you to hear his words.
Mm.
Get on your knees and pray. He will cause you to hear his words.
That's
get to that altar.
Yes.
Make an altar in your house. You don't have to fall down on your knees where you are. He'll cause you to hear his words.
Yes.
Shut out all the noise around you. Get alone with God.
Mm.
Might be in the backyard. It might be on the stairwell.
Mm-hmm.
It might be in your car.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care where it is. Get to the potter's house.
Mm-hmm.
Get to the potter's house. Let the tears flow. Raise your arms. Shout hallelujah.
Yes.
You are still in his hands.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't want anyone to perish. He wants you to be that vessel of honor. I don't care what you've done.
He wants
to make you into something.
Thank you, Jesus.
This morning.
Bless your name.
Have honor, not dishonor. I don't care if you've had dishonor your whole life. He can change you.
That's right.
He can change you. Everything you need is in the potter's house. Let's look at that, that second part of verse 4. Says, so he made it again into another vessel. I'm so glad he made, because, you know, we've done many things. I'm saying for myself, things I shouldn't have done, things I've said, thoughts I shouldn't have had. Yeah, we're just sinners. We were born into sin.
That's right.
Born into sin. But thank God that he said, Yvonne, I can make you into something new. I can make you into another vessel. Trust in him. Lean on him. Let him mold you and make you into what he wants you to be. See, maybe your heart isn't right this morning. Sometimes people have a hard heart, full of hate, anger, unforgiveness, an uncaring heart. He'll give you a clean heart this morning. Get to the potter's house. There's a song we used to sing, give me a clean heart.
That's right.
So that I may follow thee. He'll clean up your heart this morning. He'll give you a heart transplant.
Mm-hmm.
He'll give you a new outlook. He'll let you see people in a different light. Love people that you thought you couldn't love. Care for people that you thought you couldn't care for.
That's right.
Forgive people that you thought you couldn't forgive. He doesn't want you to have a hard, blackened heart. He wants you to have a heart full of love for others. A heart full of joy. A heart full of peace.
Mm-hmm.
He'll give you a clean heart.
That's right.
You got to get to the potter's
house. Yes.
Maybe you have no integrity in your life. And I was thinking about that. Maybe you lie and cheat and steal. Maybe you think that's how you have to get by.
Mm.
But he'll make you a vessel of honor this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Full of integrity. But you got to get to the potter's house. Maybe you have a business and you don't trust in him. And maybe you have a business that has no integrity and you wonder why it's not thriving. Let God make it into something
new.
That's
right.
Have some integrity. Don't open up 15 minutes late. And I know that might sound silly, but I knew a business that did that, tried to support them. Mm. But you went there and supposed to open up at 11 o'clock, it opened up at 11:30. Have integrity in your life, whatever you do. The way you walk, the way you talk, the way you dress, the way you talk to people, the way you run your business, wherever you are, have integrity.
Mm, that's good.
In whatever you do, give it to the Lord. If you sweep the floor, be the best that you can be. Have integrity. Don't sweep things under the rug and say, well, they'll never know. Don't sweep things and say, oh, they don't pay me enough to do that job. I actually have people say that all the time. He's not going to take you to another place. He can't make you into another vessel if you have that attitude. Have integrity with whatever you do. He'll make you into that vessel of honor. Even if you had dishonor, he can change it around. He can change it around. People can see that light shining through you. He can change it around. He'll make you into a new vessel.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, maybe you're a pastor this morning. I don't know. Maybe you're watching this ministry. But you're chasing money.
That's right.
Instead of souls. Mm. You're chasing that status.
That's good.
Instead of souls.
That's good.
You're chasing a name for yourself instead of winning souls for Christ. See, sometimes we get so caught up. Yeah, we want to make all the money that we can.
Mm-hmm.
We want to have all the people that can in our church. We want to have status. We want to be a big name pastor instead of having a humble heart and a humble spirit and trying to win souls for Christ. And maybe you're that pastor, that leader this morning that you fell off of that and you got too far away. Mm-hmm. He'll make you into something new. He'll make you a new vessel for him.
That's right.
So you stop chasing all of this other stuff. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
That's
and
right.
All these other
That's
things
good.
Will be added unto you. See, we get caught up. Satan wants us to get caught up in the things of this world instead of being at the potter's house.
Hallelujah.
And maybe you feel there is no hope. Oh, come on. Get to the potter's house.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Maybe you have no vision. Once you have a vision for your life, for your family, get to the potter's house.
Thank you, Jesus.
He'll give you new hope. He's the hope for the hopeless. He'll give you a vision for you. If it's just you all by yourself, if you have a family, he'll give you a vision for you and your family.
Mm-hmm.
He'll put joy in your home.
Yes, he will.
He'll put love in your home. He'll put peace in your home. He'll have a family full of integrity. You'll have a family full of love for each other. It might take a while.
Mm.
Get to the potter's house.
Mm-hmm.
Start with you. Start with you. Start changing you.
Hallelujah.
Start changing the things that you do. Don't ask people to lie.
Hallelujah.
When you say that you're not home. There's no integrity in that. Have integrity wherever you are.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you do.
That's
good. He can make you into a new vessel in your life. I don't care what walk of life you're in. He can take that bad language from you and fill it with his words.
Mm.
So people are like, what happened? What happened to that person? I'll tell you what happened. They got to the potter's house.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on. Everything you need
is in the potter's house.
In Isaiah 64:8 it says, but now, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay.
Mm.
And you are the potter. And all of us are the work of your hand. Oh, hallelujah.
Mm.
And I mean that. I don't want God to ever take his hands off of me.
Hallelujah.
I'm talking to me personally. When you go this week, just keep saying, I'm going to the potter's house.
Mm.
I'm going to the potter's house.
Yes.
Say that all week in the spirit. I'm going to the potter's house. Write it down.
Mm.
Put it on your steering wheel. I write myself notes all the time. I'm going. I put them on in my classroom, wherever I am. Sometimes I put a piece of paper and tape and put it on my steering wheel so I can see it while I'm driving to work.
Mm.
I'm going.
Hallelujah.
Satan, get away from me because I'm going to the potter's house. Satan, you can't have your hands on me because I'm going to the potter's house. Mm-mm. Satan, you can't fill me with unhappiness anymore because I'm going to the potter's house.
Yes.
Satan, you can't fill me with lies anymore because I'm going to the potter's house.
Yes.
Satan, you can't make me feel lonely anymore because I'm going to the potter's
yes.
house. Satan, you can't make me have a business full of not integrity.
Thank you.
You know, no integrity there because I'm going to the potter's house.
Yes.
Satan, you can't keep that depression on me anymore because I'm going to the potter's house. Satan, you can't make me my mind be messed up anymore because I'm going to the potter's
house.
Yes,
there it is.
Say that all week. I'm going to the potter's house.
Yes.
Get up where you're at. Go to the potter's house. Come on. Shout hallelujah.
Yeah.
I'm shouting with you. Send us that note on our website and say, I went to the potter's house. Hallelujah. Because I know now that God has his hands on me.
Yes.
I might be messed up. I might have lied.
Yeah.
And I might have done some things last night I shouldn't have done. But I got up and I went to the potter's house. Satan, you can't have your hands
hallelujah.
On me anymore. Because I'm going to the potter's house. Come on. Get up. Go to the potter's house. Hallelujah. Praise
thank
God.
Thank you, Jesus. Bless
say
your
it
name
all week.
Day.
I'm going to the potter's house.
Yes. Hallelujah.
I'm not confused anymore because I'm going to the potter's
that's
house.
That's good.
I'm not full of fear anymore because I'm going to the potter's house. And see, when he got there, oh, hallelujah, God was doing something. He was already working at that wheel. He was making that vessel into something new. Oh, he's got his hands on you. Hallelujah. Shout hallelujah with
yes.
God. Praise
hallelujah.
God. Stand up and start running around. Thank the Lord. Thank God that he has his hands on
yes,
you.
That's
get
good.
To the potter's house. There is hope. Hope in the potter's
yes,
house.
There is. Yes, there is. Thank you, Jesus.
Philippians 1:6 says, for I am confident of this very thing, that he who began a good work in you
yes.
will perfect it
hallelujah.
Until the day of Christ. God will make you into a new vessel.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
But see, sometimes we think, you know, and people put labels on us. You know, oh, they did this, they did that. I don't want to listen to them. You know who they are? They went, they committed adultery.
Mm-hmm.
They did nothing but lie. They cheated on their taxes. They, you know, they lie to get food stamps. They, you know, they always use curse words. They had no integrity. But let me tell you something. I don't care what you've done. I don't care what you did 5 minutes ago. God can use you.
Yes.
He loves you. Let's look. A couple weeks ago, I preached on the woman of Samaria. She had five husbands. And the one she was with wasn't her own. But she became an evangelist. Yes, she did. Because many were saved. She ran back into town and told them Jesus Christ, that encounter she had with Jesus Christ. She became an evangelist. Oh, yeah. She was probably a scorned woman. But she became an evangelist. Paul. Oh, yeah. We know who Paul is in the Bible. He persecuted Christians, but he became a preacher. Peter denied knowing Christ, but he became a fisher of men. David committed adultery and had a man killed, her husband, but he was the apple of God's eye and became king. Oh, yeah, God can use you. Yeah, see, they repented. They repented, and God restored them. Repent where you're at. Repent of what you're doing. God can use you. I don't care if you've had 10 wives. God can use you. I don't care if you stole this morning. God can use you. I don't care if you feel ashamed because you got caught doing something. Get back to the potter's house. Don't worry about the other people.
Hallelujah.
See, they messed up themselves. See, don't worry about who's around you. This is your soul. This is your life. It doesn't matter what people think. People are all going to think what they think. They're people. But worry about what God thinks.
That's right.
I don't care who you are. They might talk about you when you walk up there. That's all right. You might start a ministry and they might say, how are they going to minister? Because all the things don't matter. If God's called you to it, don't worry about what they say. You might be a prayer warrior and say, how are they going to pray for me? They were just full of sin. God can change you.
That's right.
Do what God is speaking to you this morning. Do what God has told you to do. I don't care what it is. Maybe he said, quit hiding stuff when you go to work. Quit taking, you know, things home that don't belong to you. I don't know what it is. That just came to my mind. I don't know. You know where you are.
Mm-hmm.
God knows where you are. He knows your heart. He can make you a new vessel. Praise God. As I said, look at all these people in the Bible. God used them. He can take the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. He can use you. If he can use me, He can use you.
Hallelujah.
Because, see, I'm just a shy person. Shy, and I've made lots of mistakes in my life. You're not outspoken, not bold, but I pray for boldness. But God called me into the ministry. He called me to
preach the word of God. Amen, amen.
And I'm not going to let anybody stop me from that until the day I die, proclaiming the good news of Jesus.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Lord.
We're soul winners for Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
He can use you. I don't care what you've done. I don't care if you robbed a bank. I don't care if you, it doesn't matter. God could change your life. He could make you into a new vessel. Hallelujah. One thing I was looking at, I tell you, when reading those four scriptures, those four verses, God brought so many things out to me. Praise God. So, when Jeremiah got to that potter's house, God was doing something at the wheel.
Yes, he was.
He was forming that clay. He was marred in his hands. But what does a potter use when he's making that clay, when he's forming that clay? You can't just pick up that dry clay. Got to have something on it. What does it have to have on it? Water. What is that water? That Holy Spirit.
Hey, that's good. That's good.
See, that vessel is an empty, hollow container. But God wants to fill it with that Holy Spirit. He wants to fill it with his Spirit, the Spirit of God, through faith in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah, because you got to have that water to mold that clay into something new. You got to have Jesus Christ. You got to have that Holy Spirit.
Yes, hallelujah.
What's in the potter's house? Everything you need is in the potter's house. Mm-hmm. Salvation is in the potter's house.
That's right.
Love is in the potter's house. Yes. Peace is in the Father's house. The potter's house. Excuse me. Joy is in the potter's house.
Yes.
A new heart.
Hallelujah.
Is in the potter's
house.
Thank
you, Jesus.
Integrity is in the potter's house. Hope is in the potter's house. Deliverance is in the potter's house. Healing is in the potter's house. Everything you need is in the potter's house. He can mold you into something new. Mm-hmm. He can give you peace of mind. Mm-hmm. He can get that depression off of you if you're depressed this morning. He can fill that lonely void this morning. He could bring you happiness.
Thank you.
Deliverance, whatever addiction you're having. Mm. There is deliverance in the potter's house.
Good.
I'm so glad that he was making something at that wheel. So it says God was making something where? At the wheel. At the wheel. Oh, come on. See, there's nothing. The words in the verse of the scriptures is not there by accident. This has meaning to it. God's words have meaning. So it says he was making something at the wheel. See, when clay is put on the potter's wheel, it needs to be in the center of the wheel. What is that center? Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ needs to be the center of your life. Hallelujah. See, he wants to fill you with his Spirit. He wants to fill you with that Holy Spirit so that you become the vessel that he wants you to be through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So I'm going to close out on this. If you don't know him, say, I want to get to the potter's house this morning. I want to be made new this morning. I want Jesus to be the center of my life this morning. Jesus Christ needs to be at the center of your life. I'm going to have you say this prayer with me, so I'm going to repeat that again. If you want to be a vessel filled with the Holy Spirit, if you want Jesus Christ to be the center of your life,
yes,
say this prayer with me. Oh, we're just here to win souls for Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Open up your heart.
Yes, yes, yes.
Open up your mind.
Thank you.
Say this prayer for eternal life with me this morning. Dear Heavenly Father.
Dear Heavenly Father.
I come to you in the name of Jesus.
I come to you in the name of Jesus.
I am a sinner and need your forgiveness.
I'm a sinner and need your forgiveness.
I believe that your only begotten Son.
I believe that your only begotten Son.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Shed his blood on the cross.
Shed his blood on the cross.
And died for my sins.
And died for my sins.
And now I want to turn from my sins.
And now I want to turn from my sins.
I confess with my mouth.
I confess with my mouth.
The Lord Jesus.
The Lord Jesus.
And believe in my heart.
believe in my heart
that you raised him from the dead.
That you raised him from the dead.
I invite Jesus Christ to come into my life.
To come into my life.
As my personal Savior.
As my personal
Thank
Savior.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For dying for my sins.
For dying for my
and
sins.
And giving me the gift of eternal life.
And giving me the gift of
amen,
eternal life.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen,
Romans
amen.
Romans 10:9 says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus.
Yes.
And believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Go to the Potter's house. Praise God. Say it every day. I'm going to the Potter's house.
Yes. Hallelujah.
God bless you, everybody.
Yes.
God bless you.
Yes.
I pray that you have hope this morning through Jesus Christ. I pray that you let God fill you with his Holy Spirit anew. I pray that souls are saved.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. I'm going to hand it back over to my husband. God bless you, everybody.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hey, thank you again for tapping in. I seen some of you were tapping in. And when you tap in, don't tap out. Stay there because God's got a word for you. The devil wants you to move. Don't move. Just park your little self down because I know if you're like me, you're facing some thing. But God hadn't forgotten about you. Hey, that was an anointed word from my wife, Reverend Yvonne Pettiford. I thank God for her. I thank God for using her to be that instrument. Hey, get to the Potter's house.
Amen.
Let me see that cross again, sweetheart, on the floor. Get to the Potter's house.
Amen.
You got to get there. You got to get there. See, this is where Jesus died for you and me.
Hallelujah.
Hey, get to the Potter's house. Get to the cross. Get to where he wants you to be. Get back in your rightful place. Get back in your rightful lane. Some of you have been going the wrong way down the one-way street.
Hallelujah.
Hey, do a U-turn. Get back on. Hey, that was an anointed message because it said, I'm not going to repeat everything. Step on her message. But you got to get to the Potter's house.
Hallelujah.
That's where the anointing is. That's where the blessings are. That's where the covering is.
Yes.
Some of you are out there too far. You don't have a covering.
Mm.
That's why as you're trolling through, you see lie. Let me see what they're talking about. We're talking about Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who loves you.
Yes.
Hadn't forgotten about it. You. How important God you are to God. He knows how many hairs you have on your head.
Yes.
Hey. That's how much he loves you. Get back to the Potter's house.
Hallelujah.
Get back to the foot of the cross.
Yes.
Get back into your rightful place. God's not mad about you.
No.
You hadn't gotten too far. Come on back.
Yes.
If you're still living, you still can hear the sound of my voice. That means you can still get back. When you can't is when you die and don't know Jesus and find yourself parked in hell, burning forever. You don't want to be there. Get back to this cross. Hey, we love you. We're here every Thursday, Lord willing, 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Tap in for Hope in the Word Thursday. Let someone else know. Tap and share this with someone else. They may not be on Facebook where some of you are watching. Some of you are watching on our webpage, hopeintheWordMinistries.com. Thank you for watching there. Hey, shoot us a prayer request, as I said at the beginning of the ministry. If you need prayer, do me a favor. Go to our website, hopeintheWordMinistries.com. Click on prayer request. You don't have to put your name. Just send us that prayer request. We'd love to pray for you. Go there anyway and let us know. Type in a comment on there. If you're watching live or later on Facebook, hey, type us a something and say, hey, I watched you. Hey, I'm praying for you. Hey, I need prayer. Don't tap out. Continue to tap in. There's many ways to watch us. You can go to our webpage later if you missed us live somewhere on our website, on Facebook. Go back to our webpage. We post our sermons there later. See, you can't miss us. Pretty soon, I keep telling you, if you put on PlayStation, we're coming live to a PlayStation audience. We believe God's given us anointing to go around the world.
Amen.
We're not for everybody, but we're for somebody.
Amen.
We might be for you this Sunday morning. And as I close, go to our webpage anyway, www.hopeintheWordMinistries.com. Pass that on to someone else. HopeintheWordMinistries.com to your friends, your family members, those your co-workers. Hope in the Word. Hope in the Word. We're bringing hope in God's Word. HopeintheWordMinistries.com. Check us out there. We got things for kids on there if you got children. Go there and visit. If you want to search something on the Bible, there's a link that we have on there to search something. Hey, we're trying to do what we can. So don't blame God. Blame yourself if you're not tapping in. Like I said, but most of all, this is where it all starts at the cross. It's not about me. It's not about my lovely wife. It's about Jesus Christ of Nazareth, our Lord and our Savior, and what he done on the cross for you and me. He loves you. He hadn't forgotten about you. Hey, there's hope. But that hope starts with Jesus. Everything is in the potter's house. Get you a covering. Hey, we'll see you Thursday, Lord willing, 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. We're here Sundays. Let someone know. 10 a.m. Mountain Standard Time. We're coming live from the Valley of the Sun, Phoenix, Arizona. Hey, we put the cross down, and that's where we're going to be. Serving Jesus, if it's just one. But will you help us? Do what we're called to do. Go to our website. Your gift, large or small, your financial gift will help us to do what we're doing. Send us a gift. I know God will bless you.
Amen.
Send us that. You know he's speaking to you. Some of you right now, some of you later as you tapped in. God bless you. We're praying for you. Don't you give up. You're so close to your miracle. Get to the potter's house. Hey, Lord willing, we'll see you Thursday. Be blessed. Hey, keep the faith. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes. Thank you.
Amen.
Yes. Thank you. In the potter's house.
Yes.
Get to the potter's house. Everything you need is in the potter's house. Hey, before we go, everything you need is in the potter's house.
Amen.
Joy is in the potter's house. Peace is in the potter's house.
Hallelujah.
Victory is in the potter's house.
Amen.
Everything you need is in the potter's house. You get to the potter's house. You keep believing God. I don't care what you're facing.
Hallelujah.
You need to kick the devil to the curb, tell him to kick rocks. Get out of your life. Get out of your children's life, your husband's life, your wife's life, whatever you're facing. If you got cancer in your body, we rebuke that in the name of Jesus. If you got depression, we rebuke that in the name of Jesus. Oh, Larabasana, get to the potter's house. Honey, I don't know if you got anything to share with him. Close out in the prayer in the name of Jesus. I feel him right now. Oh, get to him. Get to
him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Lord.
Thank
Jesus.
You, Jesus.
Somebody needs to get to the potter's house. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you that you don't throw us away. Just get on your knees and pray and thank God that he loves you. Thank God that he didn't throw you away. I want somebody to just lift up their hands right now.
Yes,
just
yes,
whoever
yes.
you are, that Hallelujah. You might be in a depressed state. You might be crying tears right now that you just think God doesn't love you. Satan's still working on you. We're going to pray that off of you this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Clear their mind.
Yes, yes.
Get Satan's hands off of them. Clear their mind, their heart, their spirit, whoever you are.
Thank you.
Know that God loves you.
Yes.
He didn't throw you away. Thank you. Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Hallelujah.
Thank you that you sent your son, Jesus
yes.
Christ,
move,
die on that
God.
Cross.
Move,
that
Father.
We would have eternal
Touch.
Life.
Hook
that we would have salvation.
Thank you, Jesus.
That thank you that we can get to that potter's house.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Thank
Let
you.
Them know. Let them know.
Yes.
That Jesus Christ paid it all.
Hallelujah.
He paid it all.
Yes, he did.
On the cross.
Hallelujah.
So you don't have to sit there. He'll
Hallelujah.
Be your friend. He'll be your father.
Yes.
He'll be your mother. He'll be your sister.
Bless
He'll
you.
Be your brother. He's everything that you need.
Yes.
Get to the potter's
Get
house.
Get to the potter's house. Thank
Whoever
you,
is sitting there.
Hallelujah.
Heart heavy. Let that person feel the Holy Spirit wrapped around them.
Hallelujah.
Let them know that the Heavenly Father loves them. And that Jesus Christ died for them.
Yes, 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 yes. Thank you.
So I'm praying for deliverance of souls. Right now.
Thank you.
Right now. That chains are breaking off of people.
Hallelujah.
Right now. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you. That somebody's going to be made into a vessel of honor today. That chain of dishonor is falling off of them. Right now, that they can feel those chains falling off. And they can shout hallelujah. Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Thank you.
We just thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for the delivered souls this morning. Thank you, the hope that was given back to people this morning.
Bless you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Bless you, Jesus.
To whoever ran to the Potter's
house. Hallelujah,
you know,
hallelujah,
I don't know.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
And the souls
hallelujah.
That were won, the angels in heaven. Rejoice.
Thank you.
And we're rejoicing. We just thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name
in
we
Jesus
pray.
Name.
You don't have to stay in the shape that you're in.
Yes.
Because the Potter, he wants to pick up the fragments, the broken pieces of
yes.
your
yes. Bless you, Jesus.
He wants to put you back together.
Mm.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We love you. Jesus loves you.
Mm.
God bless you, everybody. That's just the way it is. Have a blessed day. And be joyful in the Lord. The joy of the Lord is my strength. Be joyful today. Why? Because God loves you. And Jesus Christ died on the cross for you. And that Holy Spirit will come.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank
you.
You,
Heavenly Father.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Yes.